I remember coming into class, it was either third or fourth period, and I'd laid my head down.
16-year-old Cameron Kosunick says he was tired and not feeling well when he went to school at Liberty Prep in Smithville August 30th.
I go to work right after school, so I get off the bus like 3 and then I immediately go to work until like 10 or 10:30. And
at night when he comes home from work, he doesn't want to go right to sleep. And you know, it takes him a little while to wind down.
When he fell asleep in the school's learning lab, a teacher and principal woke him up.
I laid my head back down, and when I laid my head back down, I closed my eyes.
And that's when school resource officer Marissa Boskowski abruptly decided to try and get his attention by arcing her taser.
She apparently thought that it would be effective to arc her taser, making just the sound, not actually putting it in contact with the student and not shooting the probes out of the taser or anything.
Because I just had heard the loud noise and I kept my eyes closed and then everybody was talking like it was loud, people saying about how she had her taser out.
The school alerting parents with this letter, saying at no time was any student in any kind of danger. Okay. Chief Howard Funk says even though no one was harmed, drawing the taser in a school under those circumstances violates department policy.
The situation brings up a number of concerns, mainly from the policies that are involved with the use of the taser and with our response to resistance and aggression.
How I feel about the situation is she didn't think it through clearly.
Boskowski is on administrative leave while Chief Funk says he decides the appropriate next step.
She needs to know that that wasn't right, that she shouldn't have done that in any circumstance unless she was in danger.